time?
Yeah, okay. The next speaker is Ilaria Drago. Her talk is inhibition of mitochondrial calcium entry in mushroom body neurons during pupariation causes memory impairment and neuronal structural defects in adult flies.
Good afternoon. Before starting, as the other speaker, I would like to thank the organizer for the possibility to present my results. Many studies have already demonstrated a correlation between mitochondrial health and cognitive function. However, which of the many mitochondrial functions are specifically important for cognition is still not clear. In our study, we investigated the hypothesis that the ability of mitochondria to participate in cellular calcium homeostasis is one of the mitochondrial functions that are important to support cognition. Whenever there is an increase in cytoplasmic calcium, this second messenger enters the mitochondrial matrix, and this phenomenon is known to regulate, among many other cellular functions, metabolism, overall cellular calcium signaling, and cell death. Mitochondrial calcium entry was studied for decades in cellular calcium in cellular models. However, the molecular identity of the proteins that mediate mitochondrial calcium entry happened just a few years ago. Now we know that the mitochondrial calcium uniporter complex is composed by a pore-forming subunit that is named MCU, and by different regulatory subunit, the most important study of which are MIQ1 and MIQ2, that together sense the changes in cytoplasmic calcium and keep the channel closed in steady state condition, while they increase the opening probability of MCU when there is an increase in cytoplasmic calcium. Given the importance of the cellular function mediated by mitochondrial calcium entry, there was a great interest toward the generation of animal knockout models for the protein that mediate mitochondrial calcium entry after they were identified a few years ago. However, surprisingly, MCU knockout mice display only a very mild muscle phenotype, thus casting some doubt on the real importance of mitochondrial calcium entry in vivo for physiological processes. However, in 2014, there was the identification of the first human mitochondrial disease that is directly caused by mutation in proteins that mediate mitochondrial calcium entry. Indeed, patients carry loss of function mutation in MIQ1 display a learning disability, along with a skeletal muscle myopathy. The observation that MIQ1 patients have a learning disability first gave us the idea that maybe mitochondrial calcium entry is one of the mitochondrial functions that are important for cognitive processes. This idea was further strengthened by the results of a high throughput screening that was performed in the Davis lab and that had as a main goal the one to identify new genes involved in olfactory memory in Drosophila. Indeed, among the hundreds of low hits that are the protein that when silence causes a decrease in memory, MCU and MIQ1 were identified. We thus decided to investigate the hypothesis that mitochondrial calcium entry is important for olfactory memory in Drosophila. We started by asking in which specific neuronal population among the ones that are important for learning, memory, olfaction, MCU is required. We perform olfactory aversive conditioning experiments in which we train the flies to associate an odor with an electric shock, and then we test the memory of the flies by inserting them in a T-maze. The memory is quantified by a PI, in which a PI of 1 means that all the flies in the T-maze avoid the arm containing the odor previously associated with the electric shock, while a PI of 0 means that the flies have no recollection of the previous training and so they distribute totally randomly between the two arms. What we observed was that silencing MCU, specifically just in mushroom body neurons, caused a 3-hour memory decrease, as observed when MCU was silenced in the whole central nervous system. This result does map MCU function to mushroom body neurons. We then asked it in which specific memory phase MCU was required by training the flies and then testing their memory at different time points. And we observed that while the immediate memory was not changed by MCU silencing, there was a significant decrease in 1 and 3 hour memory, thus mapping MCU function to intermediate term memory phases. All these results were also confirmed by expressing a dominant negative form of the channel or by silencing MCU regulator MIQ1. In both cases, we didn't observe any immediate memory defect, but a significant decrease in intermediate term memory. For all the genetic insults that I presented so far, we verify by calcium imaging experiment that they all cause, as expected, a decrease in mitochondrial calcium entry in mushroom body neurons. Given the role of mitochondrial calcium entry in regulating metabolism or buffering calcium transients, our expectation was that mitochondrial calcium entry is required in adult flies at the time of training and testing to have a normal memory. The less likely hypothesis was that mitochondrial calcium entry was required in mushroom body neurons during development to establish a competency of this neuron that is then required in adult flies for a normal memory. To distinguish between these two possibilities, we perform a target experiment that were originally developed by Sean McGuire in the Davis lab. In this experiment, we take advantage of the temperature-sensitive form of the GAL4 inhibitor GAL80 that allow to repress the US insertion expression where the flies are at 18 degrees and to activate the expression by simply moving the flies at 30 degrees. What we observed, to our big surprise, was that silencing MCU, silencing MIQ1, or expressing a dominant negative form of the channel just during the development, but not in adult flies, was sufficient to cause the same 3-hour memory decrease that we observed when these genetic insults were present both during development and in adult flies. We then wanted to further define the developmental time window in which mitochondrial calcium entry is required for memory in adult flies. We thus synchronize brood of flies, and then we activate MCU silencing in specific developmental time window that are here shown by the color bar. What we observed was that silencing MCU from egg laying up to later distal didn't cause any defect in adult flies' memory, while on the contrary, silencing MCU from later distal up to enclosure was sufficient to cause a 3-hour memory decrease. By activating MCU expression after puparin formation, we then further close the developmental time window in which mitochondrial calcium entry is required for a normal memory in adult flies to the developmental stage of pupation. Mushroom bodies are formed by 3 different lobes that differ for their axonal projection, for their role in learning and memory, and also by their different developmental pattern. For example, during pupation, the already formed gamma neurons go through a pruning and re-extension process, and the alpha-beta neurons are formed. We wanted to know if mitochondrial calcium entry was required specifically in a subset of mushroom body neurons, and so we silenced MCU with GAL4 driver that were specific either for one of the 3 mushroom body lobes or for a combination of 2 out of 3 mushroom body lobes. And we observed that silencing MCU specifically in alpha, beta, and gamma neuron caused the same 3-hour memory decrease that we observed when MCU was silenced with a pan mushroom body neuron driver. For both the 2 specific alpha, beta, and gamma drivers, and for the PAM mushroom body neuron driver that we use for our olfactory conditioning experiment, we also checked that they were expressed during pupation, that is the phenocritical period in which mitochondrial calcium entry is required for a normal memory in adult flies. Our result suggesting that mitochondrial calcium entries require in mushroom body neurons to establish either a structural or functional competency of these neurons that is later required in adult flies for learning or memory. However, we didn't observe any major structural defect in mushroom body neurons upon MCU silencing. We so went on to perform a more fine analysis of the synaptic vesicle compartment by using as a surrogate the synaptotagmin GFP probe. Or we analyzed the dendritic compartment by using the probe DEMARC. And what we observed was that upon MCU silencing, there was a significant decrease in the synaptotagmin GFP signal, thus making us conclude that silencing MCU in alpha, beta, and gamma neuron decreased the synaptic vesicle content. Finally, we perform a single neuron analysis by taking advantage of the photoactivatable form of GFP, C3PA-GFP, that allowed us to activate single mushroom body neurons and then to track their axonal projection. We started our analysis from alpha-beta neurons, since they are the ones that are formed during pupation, that is the phenocritical period in which mitochondrial calcium entries require for normal memory in adult flies. And we observed that upon MCU silencing, alpha-beta neuron axonal projection were longer and they occupy a bigger axonal field volume. This observation was true just for alpha-beta neurons, since the same analysis in gamma neurons didn't show any change. So, in conclusion, mitochondrial calcium entry is required during development in mushroom body neurons for then having, in adult flies, a normal intermediate-term memory, a normal formation of alpha-beta neurons, and a normal synaptic vesicle content. On the contrary, when there is an impairment of mitochondrial calcium entry just during development, adult flies have an impaired intermediate-term memory, their alpha-beta neurons are longer and they occupy a bigger axonal field volume, and the synaptic vesicle number is decreased. I would like to thank my mentor, Ron Davis, all the members of the Davis Lab, and also Seth Tomczyk and Massimiliano Aceti of the Neuroscience Department at Scripps, Florida, for their help with the photoactivation experiment. And also, I would like to thank you for your attention. So the question is if I try other learning paradigm other than olfactory. No, we didn't. We just focus on that paradigm. So the question, I'm repeating, the question if I try to subdivide the developmental time period in which calcium entry is required. So you're asking if we try to make it even shorter than just the whole pupariation. No, we just try to activate MCU silencing starting from where when all the flies had formed the puparium case. So it was the whole pupariation. Then, of course, the prediction is that you have also to count that there is some time for the GAL4 to be produced, for the silencing of the protein. So probably the developmental time window actually is shorter, but we map to the pupariation, so the last part of the development.
So does the mitochondrial calcium entry change the number and the size of the mitochondria and affect other neuronal properties?
So I kind of heard the question, something with mitochondrial number. Can you try to speak louder because here?
Okay, so if you inhibit mitochondrial calcium entry, will that change the number of mitochondria in the mushroom body? And will that affect the learning paradigm that you are studying?
So your question is if impairing mitochondrial calcium entry is changing the number of mitochondria and if this in turn is having an effect. So we didn't count how many mitochondria there are in machine body neurons after impairing mitochondrial calcium entry. However, there is no data that is indicating that inhibiting mitochondrial calcium entry has an effect on the total mitochondrial number. And also from my staining of mitochondria, I didn't do a quantification, but I never noticed a change in the total fluorescence of the mitochondrial probe. So I don't think this is the case.
And my second question is that if you change the calcium entry in mitochondria, will you change the respiration pattern or the electron transport chain? And will that affect memory and learning?
So let me rephrase, you are asking me if inhibiting mitochondrial calcium entry is changing the overall ATP production of the mitochondria. Yes, this is possible because mitochondrial calcium entry is known to activate ATP production. However, this does not seem to be the mechanism that caused the intermediate term memory defect because we silence the protein that is downstream of this process, that is the pyruvate dehydrogenase phosphatase, and in that case we didn't see any change in the learning or memory of the flies. So from this experiment, at least the suggestion seemed to be that is not due to simply to an ATP decrease.
Thank you.
Thanks to you for the question. Thank you.